Good morning, Kilbourne. This is your WKHS News for Friday, April 10th, 2015. I'm Monica Thomas.
And I'm Audrey Wachtel.
Whether you had a stay vacation or went somewhere, spring break was much needed for all of us. Abby Johnson and Kahari Lindsay tell us more.
Spring break was well needed for all of us. What did you do this break?
Basically just chilled at my house.
I went to Nashville, Tennessee and had a ton of fun.
I went on a cruise.
I played a lot of soccer.
I went on a cruise to Cozumel.
I went on a road trip with Ben DeLay.
I went to the movies with a couple friends.
I went on a road trip with my friend Adam.
I just played volleyball with the team.
I just stayed home, pretty much slept all morning.
I did college visits and went to the mall with squad.
All I did was just watch television and play video games.
I went camping and celebrated my 18th birthday.
I hung out with my friends and stayed at home and took care of my dog, Baxter. He's like this big.
Well, a couple buddies and I went down to OSU and played some soccer on their turf fields.
I went to Florida.
Nothing.
Abby Johnson and Kahari Lindsay, WKHS News.
Have you ever wondered how popcorn pops? Danielle Barker did some research to find out the science behind it.
Scientists are trying to understand the deeper physics of how popcorn pops. The understandings may help how we are now teaching physics. Let's see what Mr. Sparks thinks about the physics of popcorn.
What do you know about the physics of popcorn?
Well, first of all, when popcorn, it starts with a kernel. And the kernel has three basic main components. It has the outside shell, and inside the shell has a little starchy material, and it has a little bit of moisture. And so when popcorn gets ready to pop, what happens is as you heat the kernel, okay, the moisture inside basically expands. And as that expands, it increases the pressure. And then once the pressure gets to a certain point, basically it pops the popcorn, and the pressure basically explodes and makes your white, fluffy popcorn.
How do you think the discoveries of popping popcorn will affect teaching physics?
Well, to teaching the science, a lot of times a couple of our teachers, they use popcorn in their classroom. A couple things is with the kinetic theory, molecules that are moving, and then also how does volume, pressure, and temperature affect different types of molecules or different types of things. So that's kind of where we use that in our science classes.
Do you have anything else to add?
Well, I think another big question is, you know, the sound of popcorn, you know, the popping of popcorn. I think a lot of times people have a misconception about that. It's just when the pressure is being released, that gives you the popping sound for popcorn. So it's very similar to a bullwhip that, when you hear the whipping sound, or when you hear a champagne bottle, when you pull the cork, those are very similar to those types of sounds.
A lot of things can explode under pressure, but only a few can be eaten. This has been Danielle Barker on WKHS News.
Rugby and football can often be considered very similar. Don Brown tells us the difference between the two.
People have their skepticism about rugby and football. We talked to our head football coach at WKHS, Mr. Trombay, to hear his take on both sports.
All right, being the head football coach at WKHS, what do you think are the advantages of playing football instead of rugby?
I think an advantage of playing football over rugby is you are with guys from your school. And so you have that camaraderie factor, that chemistry factor. I know that Worthington has had a rugby team, but it's been guys from both schools. And I just don't feel that there's that closeness that you would have playing with your friends from your school. Rugby does make you tougher. I mean, you know, and you can't always teach toughness, but when you're talking about a sport that really many of us played when we were little, you know, just tackling each other, you know, playing tackle football, you know, it's very similar. And so in that case, you better learn your technique the right way so that you don't get hurt. And I think it does develop a toughness.
What sport do you believe to be safer and why?
I think that football is a safer sport just because you have the safety equipment. You're wearing helmets, you're wearing shoulder pads. I don't know if it's true. Sometimes I wonder if rugby was there first and somebody said, hey, this hurts. Maybe we ought to pat ourselves. But I think because of the protective equipment, football is the safer.
All right. Do you think WKHS has benefited from having a rugby and football team?
You know, that's tough to say. Obviously, I would assume that they would be in different times of the year. But I would hope that if something like that would happen, that rugby would not pull athletes away from other spring sports. If that were the case, I think it would be.
There are both positives and negatives to both sports. Now it's your turn to decide which one you want to play. Don Brown, WKHS News.
Link Crew is accepting applications for the 2015-2016 school year. Maya Happ and Sarah Johnson tell us how you can apply.
We have some great leadership opportunities here at Kilbourne. Link Crew, or freshman mentoring, is a way to get involved and show off your leadership skills. Mrs. Clark and Mrs. Smith told us what it takes to be a Link member and what it means to the upcoming freshmen.
Why is this important?
Well, it's important because it's really the way that our freshmen get to be introduced into our building. And so the more that we can do to make that transition to high school a really good and positive one for students, the better off the students will be when they get here and the more successful they will be as students.
What kind of characteristics are you looking for in a Link leader?
Well, we're looking for current sophomores and juniors this year who are kids who really are proud of Kilbourne, who want to be a part of Kilbourne and share their enthusiasm in the school spirit.
The applications will be available in co-curricular. They'll also be attached to our website, so we're going to post it there. And we're going to ask students to fill that out. That will be available starting next Monday, and then they will be due Friday of next week, which I believe is the 17th of April. In addition to that, we're also going to hold, at the end of April, we're going to hold like small group interviews where myself and Mrs. Clark and Mrs. Gleros are going to be talking to small groups of students who are interested in becoming Link leaders. We're trying to see how good of a fit you're going to be.
And we have made some changes to the training. We've had it 2 long days, and we're going to consolidate that and make it all in one day. Also, freshman day will be before school again on Monday, August 17th, I believe. So we'll be doing that before school starts. And get those applications. Get it on the website or in co-curricular and get those completed. We need you.
Sign-ups are located either online or in the co-curricular office. Applications are due next Friday, April 17th. Ask Mrs. Clark, Mrs. Smith, or Mrs. Gleros for applications or any other questions you have. Sarah Johnson and Maya Happ, WKHS News.
Good luck this weekend as a few of our Kilbourne band students compete at the WGI Drumline World Championships in Dayton, Ohio.
Adam Green, Sarah Sisson, Katarina Tu, and Zach Walton will be competing for a gold medal with their group Connexus Independent this Friday and Saturday against groups from all over.
Good luck and bring home the gold. High school memories can fade, but a yearbook can help keep those alive. Here's a preview of what the 2015 yearbook is going to look like.
Oh, don't you dare look back. Just keep your eyes on me. I said you're holding back. She said shut up.
Good luck to softball and baseball tonight and all sports competing this weekend.
Thanks for watching and have a great weekend, Kilbourne.